Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Explore with Suchita. Today I'm going to show you a healthy sweet recipe, that is ragi halbai or ragi ginna, which is very healthy to our body. Before that, if you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that if I publish any videos you will get the notification. Please like my videos and share it with your friends also. Today I'm preparing ragi ginna or ragi halbai, which is very famous in Karnataka, especially in Malnad regions of Karnataka. So today I am taking ragi. I am adding 1 cup of ragi and another 1/2 cup. Totally today I am using 1.5 cups of ragi. In the morning I am taking this ragi and I am going to wash this and I will soak it in water. And evening I will show you the next procedure of doing ragi halbai or ragi ginna. Now you can see it's evening. I have soaked ragi for around 5 to 6 hours. Now I'm going to grind this. For grinding this I have taken a mixer jar. Now I will add the soaked ragi to this mixer jar. We have to extract milk from this ragi, so we need to grind this. Now by adding water, I will grind this. I will make a very fine paste so that I can extract milk from this. You can see now, I have grinded this. Now I am going to strain this so that I will get the milk from this. You can add water. I have taken a big pan and I am going to strain like this. Ragi is very good for health. It gives strength and energy to your body and it acts as a natural coolant during the summer season. So in summer season, if we eat this, it will naturally cools the body and it will be very tasty also. You can store it in refrigerator for 2 to 3 days and you can eat this. Once after grinding this, I have taken milk here. See, I have got this much of ragi milk, ragi extract. Again, I am going to grind this so that if anything is which is remained, I will get that also. So, I will repeat the procedure for 2 times. Now, I am again transferring this to the mixer jar and again by adding water, I will grind this. And I will again extract the milk from this. See, I have grinded this for the 2nd time. Again, I got the ragi milk. Again, I am going to strain this. If you feel that it's not grinded well, you can do it another 1 time. At last, by using your hands, you can squeeze it like this. So that we should not waste anything. So that I am going to squeeze it like this. Like this I will squeeze everything and finally I will show you how it looks. Now again I am going to strain this. You can see the pure and virginal ragi extract here in this bottom. Today for preparing this I am using aluminium pan, so that it cooks well. In steel pan it will stick to the bottom of the pan, so that it's better to use aluminium pan. You can see now, after extracting the ragi milk, I have kept this to boil. We have to stir it continuously, otherwise it will stick. It will take around 10 to 20 minutes to prepare. Now I am going to stir this. Now I have taken jaggery. This sweet I am preparing using jaggery. I am adding water. I will dissolve this and I will strain this also. See, now you can see the consistency. It is becoming thick. Like this, we need to cook it in very slow flame so that it will cook evenly. And when we cut the pieces also, you will get very good pieces. Otherwise, it's not possible to make pieces. So we need to cook it in very slow flame. As we are preparing sweet dish today, we need to add little salt so that it will give very good taste. Very little salt. You can see it will start boiling, so that we need to stir it continuously and we need to mix it well and we need to cook it. You can see the color. You can see the consistency also, it's becoming like a jam. And I will even show you at what stage we need to stop the cooking, so that we'll get good pieces of this ragi albai. Now I'm adding dissolved jaggery. You can use jaggery according to the sweet how much you want. This is just dissolved jaggery. I'm straining this. If I am having any dirt particles, it will strain. So that I'm using strainer. Now I'm going to mix this. Sugar cane. If you get sugarcane juice, you can even use sugarcane juice instead of jaggery. It will give very good taste. But sugarcane juice is not available for me today, so I am using jaggery. We need to mix it well and we need to cook it again. You can see the consistency after adding jaggery. It's very thick. I will show you how to check whether it is cooked or not. So that I have taken a bowl. In that I have taken water. I am adding one drop of this mixture. You can see now. If you touch this, see it's dissolving. Means it's not cooked. If you put in water also, it should not dissolve. At till that stage, we need to cook this. So I need to cook this for still 5 to 6 minutes. After that, I will show you. While cooking, we need to stir this. We should not stop stirring. Now I am adding cardamom. You can see it's almost done now. I will show you the consistency also. It's very thick and it's not in running consistency. Now I will show you how to check this, whether it's cooked or not. See, I have taken water in one bowl. I'm adding this. It will not fall easily. First time when I showed, it was falling very easily. See, like this. I'll put one or two drops. See, it's not dissolving. If you touch also, it will not dissolve and it will not stick to your hands. So that it's cooked well, it's in perfect consistency. Now I'm going to switch off the stove. Here you can see I have arranged plates like this. I have not applied any oil or ghee, no need to apply any oil. Now I will transfer this prepared sweet to these plates. Now I'm pouring this to plates. If you don't have big plates, you can pour it into small plates. After pouring this to plates, shake like this so this it will settle very well. I have poured it into 4 plates, 3 big plates and 1 small plate. And it's very hot. We should not close anything, any plates or any lid. It should cool. Once after cooling, we can close anything. I will allow it to cool for around 1 to 2 hours and then I will cool this, and we need to allow this to set for one overnight. I will allow it to cool and set this for overnight today. And tomorrow morning I will show you how to cut this and how the pieces will look and how my ragi halwai or ragi ghina will look like. Tomorrow morning I will show. Now I will allow it like this only. Now you can see morning it looks like this. If you touch this also it won't stick to your hand. It is well settled. Now I am going to show you how to cut the pieces. See, even it won't stick to your knife also. If it is cooked very well, it won't stick to knife. Otherwise, it will stick to knife. In whichever shape you want, you can cut it. See, easily you can remove it like this also. See, like this it will come. You can see inside also it's cooked well. It can be served with ghee. Or else if you don't want, you can eat it like that also. Now you can see very healthy and very tasty Malnad style recipe, that is sweet recipe, ragi halwai or ragi ghina is ready along with homemade ghee. Hope so you enjoyed my video. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that if I publish any videos you will get the notification. Please like my videos and share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.